taught. Number one, put your life in me. Oh, I thought I could be what I wanted to be. I thought of myself as a mighty big man. I can't even walk without you holding my hand. Come on, church. Can't even walk without you holding my hand. The mountains too high and the valleys too wide. Down on my knees, I've learned to stay. Can't even walk without you holding. Mighty name of Jesus. If there is anything among us that would hinder the moving of your spirit today, we ask you, God, to cast it away from us and make us acceptable unto you today. Grant to us, God, acceptable heart. Help us, O God, to hear thy word and to leave your word. We pray, O God and O Father, that whatever we do and whatever we say will not be by the leading of the flesh, but will be by the spirit of the true and living God. We pray, O God, today that your spirit will speak through your servants. Hallelujah. And that your people would hear, O God. And Father, O God, your word would permeate every fiber of their being and make them the people that you have created us to be. So we ask this now, Lord, in your name. Mighty precious name of Jesus. Amen. The Bible said in Genesis 12, now the Lord had said unto Abraham, get thee out of thy country, from thy kindred, from thy father's house, unto a land that I will show you. The Lord said unto Abraham, get thee out of thy country, from thy kindred, and from thy father's house. Where you going, Abraham? Unto a land that I will show you. You could imagine, Sister Gita. Pastor come and tell you the Lord tell him to move. And when you're asking, okay, Pastor, where did the Lord tell us to go? The Lord tell me he's going to show me the land. And he tell you to pack up. Pack up, we leave it. We go into the land, we have to live by faith. Hallelujah. Amen. So this is how I read this word. When I look at this word, I say, now, the Lord is not telling us about Abraham here. The Lord, Pastor, is speaking to us, new life. Yes. It's new life the Lord is speaking to you. New life. Do I have some Abraham inside of this morning? Lift your hand if you have. Do we have some Abraham in this morning?
Amen.
God is speaking. This word is about Abraham.
Yes.
But we're going to keep it real. God is speaking to us.
Yes.
Hallelujah. God is speaking to new life.
Yes.
Watch this. The Lord said unto Abraham, get thee out of thy country, from thy kindred and from thy father's house, unto a land that I will show you. Now this is the command. That's the command. Whenever we come to God, God is going to give us a command, brethren. And how the way we respond to the command will mean whether it's victory or defeat. Are you with me this morning? Hallelujah. God gave the command. But God said, God also gave a promise. Hallelujah. So God said, God is saying, my spirit cannot walk in that environment. If you want me to bless you, you must come out of that country and go to the land that I will show you, and I will bless you there. Somebody give the Lord a shout for the promise. We taking this personal today. I want us to take this word personal, because God is speaking and God is saying there is something in our lives we call it for the blessing. We have to change. We know ourselves. We're a full pastor. We're a full sister Gita. We're a full brother. But God knows our life. And God is telling us new life to sort ourselves and what is not of God. Get rid of it.
Yeah.
And he's going to bless us in a mighty way. Hallelujah. Yeah. The Bible said the just shall live by faith in God or in the word of God. The Bible said we walk by faith and not by sight. Faith is believing what is not as it is. Hallelujah. God spoke the word. The word is not what we are accustomed to. The word sounds strange in our life, in our heads. But my brothers and my sisters, because God spoke it, and we know that it's God spoke it, we believe it. Hallelujah. And we believe the word that God has spoken to us. And now we're going to walk with expectation, waiting for the manifestation of the word in the natural. Somebody give the Lord a shout. Give on him. Hallelujah. I don't know who I come to talk to today. I don't know who I come to talk to, but God give me a word. God is saying here, you got to come out from your kindred too. All your brothers and your sisters that is not saved, God is saying, I know you love them. Hallelujah. But I want you to give them some space. Seek my face and call upon my name, and I will bless you with all the blessings you need. Somebody give your blood a shout. A little quiet. God is saying, when you give them some space, you are not losing, but gaining everything in Christ Jesus. Oh, what a promise.
Hallelujah.
All the people that are in your life, that is not of God, some of them even giving you advice how to live. All these people, God says, they're hindering the blessing of God in your life. God says, give them some space. You don't hate them, you know. That is right. You don't hate them. But you got to give them some space, because they're hindering the blessing of God. When they call you on the phone, they don't want to hear the word of God, but they want to gossip. And they want you to listen. When they have their birthday, they want to call you. They want to invite you to come to the birthday, and they want you to come. But when we invite them to come to prayer meeting, when we invite them to come to the church, they're not coming. And we feel now that we are obligated to accommodate them. No! God is saying, be separated from them. And I'm going to bless you. Somebody give the Lord a shout. A little quiet in this place. Matthew 6:31 say this. Matthew 6:31 to 33 say this. What do you say? Therefore, take no thought saying, what shall he eat or what shall he drink or what are you going to wear? God knows that you need all these things. Don't worry about it. He said, God knows that you need all these things. And all these things the Gentiles seek. He said, but your Father knows you need all these things. Alright? So seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all things shall be added unto you. Hallelujah. What God saying, if you put him first in your life, sister, if you want a husband, he'll give your husband to love you and cherish you and take care of you. God is saying, if you want a house, he's gonna give you a house. If you want a car, he's gonna give you a car. If you want a job, he's gonna give you a job. Seek ye first. And all the things you need, my dear people, God said. Now, to be hard, you know. You're asking for it. It's what he's just given to you. He's just given to you. You understand me? You go to work and the boss say, look, brother Brown, I'm giving you a raise this week. All right? Next week when you go back again, you say, brother Brown, I'll give you a raise again. And you look at him and think he's going crazy. No, he ain't going crazy. It's God that's working in his heart. God that's working in his heart. It's God giving increase. So don't think he's crazy. Hallelujah. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all things shall be added unto you. Hallelujah. Come out from your father's house, he said. Come out from your father's house. What he's saying is, daddy is not. So we deal with the country, we deal with the kindred, and in the father's house. You have to come out from your father's house too. Daddy is not your source. God is the maker, God is the keeper, and God is the supplier of all good things. You understand me? So he said, God is able to supply all your needs. President Obama is not your source. The job is not your source. God is your source. And you want to hear something, Sister Lady? Sometimes the reason why the job is still open is because you're there. You believe that? This is how God does work. Sometimes, Pastor, the reason why the hospital is still open, brother, Sister Gita, is because you are there. And God is providing for you. And because God is providing, all them doctors and all them bosses above you, they're making a living because you are there. And you'll be surprised to know God remove you from there and put you someplace else. And 2 months later, you hear the same hospital that you was working in, the hospital closing down. Because you're no longer there. You understand? It's because of you. Hallelujah. Now, get out from your country. Get out from your kindred. Get out from your family house. Abraham understood the promise. Hallelujah. Do you understand the promise that God is promising in your life this morning? Mm-hmm. Are you with me here?
Yes.
We can't afford to miss this, you know. This is a message that God sent for new life that we have to understand, because God is getting ready to do some great things in this little congregation here. Amen. This is what Brother Philip believe. All of you say, I'm not a screw to the right boat.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I believe God. I believe God. When God begins to speak, as I said, and God tells you to go and sow, I don't care. The farming could be great. The drunk could be dry as chips. God tells you to go and sow, brother. You go and sow.
Yes.
Because God is able to give you a harvest.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. In the middle of the famine, in the middle of the desert, the God that we saw is able to bring forth a river of sweet water in the middle of the desert. Praise the name of the Lord. Somebody speak. Oh, give him praise in the house of God. Give the Lord praise to him. Give the Lord praise. Give the Lord praise. When Abraham understood the promise, hallelujah, my Bible says, Abraham took his wife, Lot, his brother's son, and all the substance that they had gathered, and the souls that had gotten in Haran, and they went forth to go into the land of Canaan. Into the land of Canaan they went. Abraham believed God. Abraham believed the promise, and Abraham started to walk. Do you believe God promised this morning that when you leave here, you're going to start a walk? Believing that God going to give you the victory in 2016?
Do you believe that? Do you have that faith to stand on the word of God? That when you walk out of here, you may be shouting glory now, but when you walk out of here, do you have the faith to believe that what God said, what God promised, must come to pass? Somebody give God a shout. Tell you, when I read this word, God, the Spirit of the Lord started breaking down to me. I rejoice for your life because I say, God is getting ready to do some great things here, Pastor.
Yes.
But God is saying there is some things in our lives. We got to get rid of it. He can move. But when you get rid of them stuff that doesn't belong here, God say, go move. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The Bible said, as Abraham moved, get to Canaan, start moving. The Bible said there was a famine in the land. The Bible said there was a famine in the land. The Bible said the famine was grievous. That means the famine was rough. So Abraham looked around him and he decided to seek shelter down in Egypt. God didn't want him down in Egypt. God is the God of the famine. So when you see God call you, God appoint you, and you see the storm start to the storm cloud leaf around you, don't worry. Because if God tell you to go, you know it's not going to come. Yes. And if God tell you to go and Satan don't attack you, there is something wrong. Yes. Anytime you see you standing on the promises of God, yes, and you're living a life that is pleasing to God, every demon from the pit of hell will pick up the sword against you. Yes. But there's only one thing you know. One thing you know, Brother Brown, our God is God Almighty. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. No demon from the pit of hell will prevail over you. Somebody give the Lord a shout. There was a famine in the land. So what Abraham did, he went down to Egypt. As soon as he got down to Egypt, now he had a pretty wife. God have mercy. He gone there with his pretty wife. Pharaoh's princess look at this pretty woman. But Abraham, before he get down there, Abraham said, look, when you get down there, he's a very pretty woman. So when you get down there, I will tell him he's my sister, so I will leave. Because he might kill me for you. So said, so done. As soon as he get down there, they said, oh, this pretty woman, put her in Pharaoh's house. And they put her in Pharaoh's house. Hallelujah. And the Bible said, God plagued Pharaoh's house. Hallelujah. With great plague, not a little plague, with great plague just because of Sarah. Touch not the Lord anointing. Oh, hallelujah. My God said, touch not my anointing, I do my prophet in the home. Oh, give him praise. Yes. So Pharaoh realized his problem is because of Sarah. He sent them away. He sent them away. Hallelujah. My brothers, this morning, I want to let you know, when you walk with God, no weapon shall prosper. No weapon that is formed against you shall prosper. Every high mountain shall be made low when you walk with God. Every crooked path shall be made straight. Somebody give God some praise this morning. Every rough path shall be made smooth in Jesus' name. Every storm that rise against you, there shall be a great calm. Every need shall be supplied. Every yoke shall be broken. Every sickness shall be healed. Every burden shall be lifted. And all those that are bound up, God is going to loose them. Oh, we serve a mighty God. We serve a mighty God, brothers. Abraham believed the promise. And Abraham just started moving. God said it. I believe it. That's certainly for me. Hallelujah. Forward is going. Backward never. Hallelujah. What God is saying here, this, live a holy life before me. Oh, yeah. Walk humble before me every day. Hallelujah. Amen. This is the good part now. Walk humble before me this year, God said. And in this year, 2016, I'm going to make you the head and not the tail of your life. Oh yes, you will lend and you don't have to borrow. You will walk in health and not in sickness, in victory and not in defeat. God is saying here to new life, you will walk in abundance and not in lack. Somebody give God a praise. Somebody give God a praise. God say you're going to walk in abundance, new life, if you are humble before me and not in lack. Hear what God say again here. When the Spirit of the Lord revealed it to me, I had to shout. God said if you walk humble before him, he's going to take away the credit card from your hand. God said if you walk humble before him, he's taking away the credit card. God said you are humble before him in 2016. He go pay off the mortgage. He go pay off the car loan. Hallelujah. And he will make you free from the hands of the lender. Anybody believe this morning? But I feel him coming just to talk this morning. I come to deliver the message that the Lord has made on my heart for my people. Oh, hallelujah. And God said when you do that, he only bless you. Brother Reed, when he bless you, you're going to walk in the Lexus dealer. And when you walk around and the salesman come to you, and he say, Mister, what can I do? And he say, well, I like this one here. What's your God's work? You say, I like this one here. You say, okay, let's go to the desk. And he sit down on the desk and he ask you, sir, how you intend to pay for this? What company? How you gonna ask you that? How you intend to finance this? And you whip out your checkbook and you ask him, say, just name the figure. And they write. Somebody give God a shout. Are you getting me? Are you getting this one? Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's what God wants to do for new life. That's what God wants to do for new life. God wants to bless new life in a mighty way. God wants to bless new life in a mighty way, brothers. God wants to pay off all them credit card notes you have. Tear up the credit card for 2016. and put money in the bank, put money in your pocket, give you an increase. And whatever you put your hand to do, God go bless. That's what God has promised for you this year. 2016. And when God do that, brother Brown, men and women, boys and girls will know. Hallelujah.
Yes.
That is it. That God is the God Almighty.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Men and women, boys and girls will know that it is not by power, it is not by might, but by the Spirit of the true and living God. Somebody.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Oh.
And here is Abraham walking in the promise of God. Abraham moving because God promised him. You know what I believe? Abraham was moving, Pastor, with all his cattle, his donkey, his camel, his sheep, and the goat. And there was a famine in the land. No grass around, but you know what I believe? I believe, Pastor, that one mouthful of grass God put in the cow mouth, keep them for 2 months.
Yes.
One mouthful of water, keep them for 3 months. We serve a mighty God.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Yeah. The word of God said this. When God took the children of Israel out of Egypt, there was not one among them that was feeble, Pastor. There was not one sick person among them going to the promised land. God healed them all and bring them to the promise. We serve a mighty God. I want you to believe this promise that God promised new life. Hallelujah. This is not about Abraham. This is our God. Men and women, boys and girls, when they see the blessing, they will know. Not by power, not by might, but by the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. Genesis 13 says this. Abraham traveling. He ain't get to the promised land yet. And Genesis says, Abraham was rich in cattle and in silver and in gold. As he traveled into the promised land, he was already filthy rich. But I read, he didn't get to the promised land yet. And here, the Bible says Abraham was very rich.
Yes.
That means he had plenty dough. He had plenty corn. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And Abraham, at that time, Abraham was still walking to the promised land. And Abraham walking to the promised land, waiting on God to tell him, start building here, Abraham. This is home. Abraham keep moving. He feel the rich. And he ain't get to the promised land, Pastor. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want to tell somebody this evening here. God, the God that we serve, is a faithful God.
Amen.
He is a faithful God.
Yes.
What God promised, you understand?
Yes.
What God said, that's what he means.
Yes.
And what God promised must come to pass. No demon from the pit of hell could have backed the promise that God has honored for your life. The blessing that God has honored for your life, no demon from the pit of hell, Sister Georgia, have the power to abat it.
Amen.
He's going to come to you.
Yes.
And your enemy is going to look at you.
Amen.
And they will know that you serve the true and living God.
Yeah.
Woo.
Yeah.
Now one thing.
Yeah.
One thing I don't want us to lose sight of here. Remember this. I don't want you to lose sight of this from this text. In Genesis 12, 7 and 8. The Bible says this. In Genesis 12, verse 7 and verse 8. Look at it. Everywhere that Abraham went, Abraham built an altar unto God. Abraham never lost sight of God. From the time he left Haran, every place he went, and he put down his tent, Abraham built an altar to God. Oh, hallelujah. What this tells me, that Abraham was continually seeking the face of God.
Oh, yes.
Seeking his face and calling upon his name every day. Because he trusts and he believes in the true and living God. He believes in prayers. So he stayed in communication with God. Watch this. Lot also, which went with Abraham, he had flocks, herds, and tent. The command was, I want to make you a blessing. I want to bless you, and you will be a blessing. So, Lot was traveling with Uncle. So, every time the Lord bless Uncle, Uncle bless his little nephew.
Yes.
So, by the time they get to the promised land, both of them, Brother Brown, was filthy rich. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to his name. The Bible says Lot went with him. and lot of tents and everything. And here's something. They were so rich, they didn't get to the promised land yet. And they were so rich, the Bible says, the land was not able to hold them, to keep them together, because their substance was so great. Somebody give Lord a shout. I don't think I'll believe what brother said. A little quiet. Because you see this thing here? I get excited, I want to shout. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The land was not able to bear them, that they might dwell together. Why? Because their substance. The blessings were so great. They couldn't live together. They had too much cattle. Too much horses, too much donkey, too much sheep. And now the land wasn't big enough for two of them. They had to separate. Because Lot, God's men, and Abraham, God's men, they start fighting for pasture. You see how God is? You see how God is mighty? How God is faithful? God was faithful to his word. This is what I want us to see.
Amen.
God was faithful to his promise. Yes. Exactly what he told Abraham. That he caught everything come to pass. Because he said, I'm going to bless you. And I will make you great. I'm going to bless you in a mighty way. Brethren, I want you to take this word. I want you to take this word. Write this word in your heart for 2016. God is speaking to new life. This is not about Abraham this morning. Abraham is just the example. But we have to take this personally. This is what God wants us to do. God wants us to walk humbly before him. God wants us to obey his word. God wants us to live a holy life before him. God wants us to be righteous before him. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Because God is faithful. Whatever God said, that's what he means. And whatever God promised must come to pass. God said in his word, 2 Corinthians 6, 17 and 18, come out from among them. Come out from among them and be separated and touch not the unclean things. And I will receive you, said the Lord God of heaven. Brethren, this, don't worry what is going on around. Don't you worry what going on in Wall Street. Don't you worry what the economy is doing. God said, he's going to bless new life. And he's going to make new life great. I believe. You could say, Brother Philip, nuts if you want, I don't care. I just believe the word that God said. And I believe that in the months to come, Pastor, you're going to have to put the chairs outside. You got to bring up those chairs and put them in the aisle. Because you see, the people in Brooklyn will hear that God is blessing his people in your life. And they're all going to come over here because they want to get somebody blessing.
Oh, yeah.
The people in Brooklyn want to hear that the people that come to new life, when the pastor and the brothers lay hands on them, they get healed. And they're going to be flocking. But God just asking us here to live a holy life. God is asking. God is asking us, brethren, just leave holy before. And leave everything to me. Sister, I heard you say, the purpose in your heart this year to seek God's face and call upon his name.
Yes.
But I want you to know something, my dear sister. You don't need no books. This is the book.
Yes.
Don't go buying no books when nobody writes on prayers.
No.
Don't waste your money.
No.
All you need to petition the throne of God. He's a clean hand and a pure heart. Somebody give me a shout. That's all you need. And you get down in your corner. You make your heart. And you speak to your father. Tell him where you're hot. Tell him what you need. Tell him what trouble you. You will hear and you will answer. Righteousness exalt the nation. Righteousness exalt the nation. See. Is a reproach to the people. Jesus said this. Jesus said, if you abide in me, and my word abide in you. You hear what you go? If you abide in me, you stay where I put you. You do what I tell you to do, and the word is in you. Jesus said, ask what you want. Ask what you will. And it shall be done. All you need, you have to be abiding. A guy sent me a letter. He tell me that he's a prophet. And the Lord tell him to write me the letter. And if I want the blessings, or want a double portion blessings, to get the blessing is $30. The double portion blessing is $77. You understand what I say? And then when I sell him the $77, he go pray for me. And God go bless me. So what happened to Brother Philip? What happened to Brother Philip? What happened to Pastor Williams? What happened to Sister Gita? What happened to Brother Reed and Brother Brown? Brother Brown, you can't pray for Brother Philip. You understand where I come from? A lot of people go for that nonsense. But Jesus said to his disciples, he said, seek of God. This is the disciples now. Those that believe and serve in God. He says, seek of God, you're going to find. He says, ask of him, and he will give you. He says, if you knock at his door, he will open the door and let you come in. Hallelujah. This is how we go with God. Righteousness exalts the nation, but sin is a reproach to any people. The songwriter said, when we walk with the Lord in the light of his word, what a glory he shed on the way. And when we do his good will, he abides with us still, and with all that we trust in him. So when we, the key here is, is trusting and obeying. Humble yourself under the mighty hands of God. God said it, Brother Reed. It don't make no sense to you, but as long as he said it, you just do it. That's settled it. Brethren, this is the word that the Lord has laid on my heart to deliver to my brethren. And I pray that you receive it and that you will act upon it. Because as I tell you, I am expecting to hear of great things happening here by the power of the Spirit of God. Give the Lord a shout and praise the Lord.